Hey, y'all, it's your favorite Unc. Make sure you hit that subscribe button down below to Nightcap YouTube channel so you never miss a single live stream or video of myself, Ocho, and Gil. Remember, Nightcap doesn't happen without you. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. Thank you. Travis Hunter wore a bland t-shirt after Richard Sherman comments. There was a lot of buzz on social media about some of the pregame interaction. We got that video. What do we got?
What happened? What Sherm say about Buddy?
We got Sherm's. Okay. He said he was saying that his skills defensively, second right. to none. He's a true corner. He has tremendous instincts, great ball right. skills. But right. he said that he was bland as a receiver. I get what Sherman's saying, that he's not a like Chase and Jefferson polished receivers.
Okay.
That's what he said. Like, he's an athlete playing receiver. And because he's so much more athletic than a lot of people that's defending him, he's going to make a play.
Okay. I understand.
So that's not the way
he took offense to it.
Okay. I think Coach, Time put Sherm and Trav in contact with each other, and they were able to have a conversation. Look, he says, as a receiver, I just think he's kind of bland. Sherman, a former NFL cornerback. Remember, Sherm was a wide receiver. He went to Stanford as a wide receiver. He ended up moving to a defensive back. Okay. Said on the Lions, St. Brown podcast, St. Brown asked Sherman if he thinks Hunter can play both wide receiver and cornerback in the NFL. Sherman said, hell no. You know that, right? You're talking crazy. But there's been a lot. You and I think, yes, he can play packages, but nobody, I don't believe anybody think he's going to play every snap on offense, every snap on defense. Nobody believes that.
As a former NFL player, I know a thing or two about high performance, and that's why I drive the BMW 7 Series. This car has everything I need. It's big enough, comfortable enough, and luxurious enough to meet even my high expectations. When I'm behind the wheel of the BMW, I'm not just driving a car, I'm driving legacy. What I love most is the precision engineering, cutting-edge technology, and unmatched style. Whether it's spacious interior, the powerful engine, or the smooth ride, BMW makes sure every detail is on point. I trust BMW to deliver the ultimate driving experience, and I know you will too. So why wait? Head over to BMWUSA.com. Check out models like the Sporty X3, the all-electric i4. Build your dream car today and join me in experiencing luxury and performance that only the ultimate driving machine can offer.
Do we believe that he can be a defensive back and have a package of plays on offense? Yes. Yeah. Because we've seen it before. We've seen Prime do it. Champ Bailey, Charles Woodson. There have been a couple of guys. J.J. Watt had a couple of packages as a defensive lineman. But to play every snap, so the NFL, so to try to play 120 snaps in an NFL game?
Like, listen, you'll have to have the endurance of the Ethiopian runners.
Yeah.
So to fit you, that's the kind of endurance you're going to have. But when I think about it, I mean, when I think about Travis Hunter and how special he is, even at the receiver's position, I understand what Sherman's talking about in a sense, but I understand. I'm also understanding how much work and how much time he has to work on his craft from a receiver standpoint. He's so athletic and gifted. Once they sharpen up all the tools, man, it's a wrap. If he gets drafted, he has to get drafted as a wide receiver anyway, because that's where the money is. That's where the money. I see Travis.
I think he'll be better suited. Forget the money, Ocho. Forget the money. Where can I thrive? Where's my best chance to be the most productive player I could possibly be? I think it's on the other side of the ball.
Don't do me like that. He got to play receiver. He got to play receiver because you got to understand the money is on the receiving end now, and then the packages at the DB. Boom, they got to give you like a little bonus for that.
Ocho, hold on. What packages?
When he get to the NFL, he gonna have small packages. Like at nickel, he could be the nickel on third.
I bet you he'll play more snaps on defense and offense. And I bet he gets it.
No. Listen. As his agent, he probably ain't gonna hire me. But as his agent, I'm telling him, man, buddy, man, listen here, man. Let me tell you something. You want to play receiver? You got receivers making $30 million a year. So by the time it's time for you to get paid, you talk about 45, maybe 50. As a matter of fact, they got to pay you 50 because you play both sides of the ball. We can integrate that into your contract, you know, and you know, the fine print.
Okay.
What you talking about? Nah.
I just believe.
You don't want them on the defensive end. They get underpaid.
I'm just looking at it from a skill set and right. where his skills are right now. He's a much better defensive back than he is a wide receiver.
I don't agree with you.
Okay.
I don't agree with you simply for the fact that what he's doing on defense is instinctive based on watching film and knowing what's coming, as opposed to looking at what he can do at receiver.
Ocho, and let me ask you a question. How many comebacks have you seen him run?
Huh?
How many comebacks have you seen him run?
Well, I have, Ocho.
What you mean you haven't? That's a wide receiver, and you haven't seen him in 2 years.
Whoa! Wait a minute! Yes. Don't jump down my throat now.
I'm just asking. Normally, receivers got to run comebacks.
I've seen him. He could probably run comebacks.
I've seen him make plays. I said, Ocho, how many comebacks have you seen him run?
Well, maybe they don't have comebacks in that offense.
Ocho, come on now.
You asked me how many comebacks have I seen him run. Well, if they don't have comebacks in that offense, what you want me to say?
How many digs?
Oh, I done seen him run a dig. I've seen him run a dig and come out the back door. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. I seen him catch a slant and reverse field and come back out where he ran the slant at.
Ocho, I'm just saying, looking at him, studied for since he's been at Colorado, watched him a little bit at Jackson State, because a lot of when they came on ESPN, I would pay attention.
Right.
But watching him, I think his skill set. Right. DB is far
better suited.
Far superior because, okay. like I said,
okay.
he's a natural DB. He could just roll out of bed like, hey, I got old boy right here.
His back pedal,
the way he can back pedal, and the way he can transition.
Right.
Now, you know, in order to play receiver, these guys will choke you out here if you can't release.
Oh, see, that I don't know about that part of his game. I don't know about that. His lateral movement is his lateral
he
movement.
He seems like lateral. A long strider though.
Right. He is.
He's tall. He's taller than you think. He's like 6'3".
Yeah, we could work on that.
He's tall. He's taller than you think.
We could work on that. He come train with me. Train with me for 3 months. Man, listen, I get him open in the phone booth.
But then
all we got to do is shorten up your gait, shorten up your steps. And once you get out that dead area off the line, then you can open up all you want.
I think he's phenomenal. He's as good an athlete that I've seen with my own eyes, and I've seen some pretty good ones. Like I said, I came in the year after time, and so I watched him, and I was in the league when Bo was in the league. They're two of the greatest athletes. You know, when you can play a professional sport, two, baseball and football.
True. I played three, but go ahead. Yeah, I'm with you.
I mean, everybody in the NFL played three sports in high school, but to do it professionally.
Right. That was me. Yeah.
So it's unbelievable. Like I said, I just want to see him. I think he's better suited. At the end of the day, I don't think he has to make a decision. I think team's gonna help him make that decision. They're gonna say, son, we're gonna give you some packages on the offensive side of the football. See, Ocho, you're looking at it from a pure monetary standpoint.
I'm looking at it from the best.
Look, for me, a monetary standpoint, hell, a wide receiver. But where could I make my bones? What could I be the best at? Tight end.
I'm telling you, man.
Here's the fact. I'll give you an example. If he had Tyreek speed, I was like, okay, you're right.
But you don't have to have that kind of speed. That's unnecessary.
No, but guys that don't have that kind of speed, what can they do? And tell the people at home, for guys that don't have Tyreek speed and they play wide receiver, what can they do, Ocho? You couldn't touch them in a phone booth. They're technically sound. There's a reason why Steve Largent, when he retired, had all the records. He ran 4.7, but he was a route running technician. guys that can't, that aren't speed merchants, they can run the route tree and make every route look the same. The release, the slant, looks just like the quick out, looks just like the smoke, looks just like the over, looks just like the end, the comeback.
He's fast, though. He fast. He 4.3. He 4.3. And if he's not 4.3, he will be by the time in draft time. Like 4.2 is great. That's a great tool to have in your toolbox, but you don't literally have to be 4.2 to be effective. Look at Justin Jefferson. Look at Jamar Chase.
Ocho, you're talking about elite receivers that run routes. You just said you haven't seen them run the whole tree.
Oh, yeah, I mean, I haven't, because it's not a part of their offense. Their specific offense. But what I do see him do, I know what he can do when he get that ball in his hands.
Yes.
I know
that. Ocho, you know how good these DBs are if you can't consistently release. They will eat you in your chest.
Right. Yeah.
Any weakness.
We're going to work on that. We're going to work on that. I got you.
That's what I'm saying. Right. But I don't know even if his releases will ever be where his DB skills are. Some things he just got God given
right out the bed.
He just woke up. God made that angle, that long angular body.
Right.
He could be fluid. He can back, because normally, you know, guys that are corners that are long, you know, it's hard for them to flip their hips. Mm-hmm. He can flip his hips.
Yeah, natural.
He can flip his hips. And that's what you got to be able to do, Ocho, because you got to be able to turn and run. You got to be able to turn and drive. You got to be and come forward.
Hey, you know I used to give him hell, boy, back in 87, boy. Huh? Shit. I know what you're talking about.
Yeah. Time said, had I just like focused like on being a wide receiver, focused on that, I could have went to Hall of Fame. And he could have, because he had that kind of speed. You got to realize, the time is 4.2.
Oh, two. Oh, easy.
Legit 4.2.
And it looked like he ain't goddamn running damn near sometimes.
It didn't, but he could fly.
Yeah.
I don't know if you guys are old enough to like, I just wish, like some things that you needed to see, like TV doesn't do it justice.
No, you got to see it in person, huh?
To watch Barry Sanders in person, to watch Prime, to watch Jerry, to watch Steph Curry shoot a basketball, to watch LeBron, to watch Jordan, to watch Kobe. Some things can only be seen through the eyes.
Yeah.
Watch Serena. To hear that ball come off Serena's racket. I know sometimes it gets drowned out, but to hear it, you like, oh my. I mean, it sounds like, if you're from the South, you know what I'm talking about, when you took the rug out and you hung it over the fence or the clothesline, and you took the broom and you poof.
Boom. Yeah.
Boom. That's what the ball sounds like jumping off Serena's racket. Then you got an appreciation. Okay, now I see what y'all talking about.
Yeah.
To see Reggie at his prime, to see the Ed Reeds and the Ray Lewis's, some things you really literally had to see.
Yeah.
In the state, you need to be in the stadium to really, really appreciate it.
Yeah.
I enjoy watching him play. I mean, he's a phenomenal talent. I love watching him play.